Masa apa ya? Masa my style. Oh, wow, alamak. Ngada. Ayo aja, ngada. Okey. Oleh kerana kan ngada-ngada ni, kita akan masak sesuatu yang dah lama tak masak. I haven't cooked this for a very, very long time. I've checked on my YouTube video. The video was a bit of a bad quality. No lights, nothing. You know when you just started. Bila saya bikin video ni dah bertahun-tahun. Years ago. I think more than 10 years lah. Lebih pada 10 tahun. Dekat YouTube. Video quality dia agak tak bagus. And tak ada lampu. Tak ada apa. You know those were the days when iPhone was like iPhone 5, iPhone 7. Kan now it's like 14, 15 lah. Alamak. Okay. So today gonna cook the peranakan sambal crab. Okay. Sambal ketam peranakan. Yang agak sedap sekali. It's been a very very delicious sambal. Okay. And it's very easy. Senang aja. Everything all just put in one go. And bring to boil. Just the same way as you cook the sambal. But you have a lot of other things. Which you think is a bit difficult. Awak ingatkan agak lebih rumit. Tetapi tidak. Okay. So I don't talk so much. Okay. So come on with me. We show how to make the peranakan sambal crab. Ataupun sambal ketam peranakan. Haa. 13 bawang besar, 3 large onion. This one is one whole onion eh. So 3 large onion, 13 bawang besar. Kita masukkan dalam blender eh. Put into blender. Okay. And then I have 2 large 2 lemongrass, 2 batang serai, 3 inch of ginger, 3 inci halia, 2 inci lengkuas, 2 inch of galanggal, and 4 clove of garlic, 14 bawang putih, 3 inci kunyit fresh turmeric 3 inch dan juga sedikit belacan. Okay, about 1 tablespoon of belacan or shrimp paste they call it eh. I have 1 tablespoon of tamarind. Okay, saya ada satu sudu makan asam jawa. Okay, I mix it in the water sedikit, mix it, gaulkan bersama sedikit air. Saya tuangkan air dia kat dalam ni sedikit saja. Okay, just pour a little bit. Agak-agak dia boleh kisar lah. Okay, make sure that you can blend, alright. Then straight away you blend everything. Awak kisarkan semua. Halus eh. Okay, straight away put inside the pot. Masukkan dalam periuk lah eh. On the stove. Tak ada minyak eh. No oil yet. Chili kisar ataupun chili bow. Chili paste. If you don't have chili paste, you can use around 20 stick of dry chili. Bring to boil and blend. This one is ready, pre-made ready. Yeah? So it's without cuka. Means no vinegar. Okay. 500 gram. 500 gram. Alright. Also we put inside the pot. We saute for a while. Kita masak lah seketika eh. The smell reminds me, bring me back to memory. Baunya membawa saya kembali ke memory zaman yang saya bikin sambal ni eh. Bring me back memory to the days which I made this sambal many 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 years ago. Kita masak dulu eh. Jangan taruh minyak sampai air dia kering eh. We cook until the water all completely evaporated. I haven't put the oil yet. Saya belum taruh minyak lagi eh. Okay. Because when I put the oil, bila saya taruh minyak nanti dia percik. It was spilled out. So I'm going to try to evaporate the water first eh. Because just now we put asam water right. Actually can just put tamarind pulp. Patutnya boleh taruh asam keping kalau tak nak leceh sangat. Okay, up to you. Everybody have their own individual preference. Awak tengok dia dah stop eh. It's already stop boiling. Dia dah berhenti menitik eh. Awak boleh taruh garam. You can put in your salt. Terserah pada anda. Aku dulu. I I cook this with a very high flame. Saya masak ni dengan api yang deras. Sebab tu dia berasap eh. With higher flame. Because I want it to expedite very quickly. Alright. Masak sambal ni. Saya boleh menggunakan api yang deras. So that it can evaporate. Ataupun dia akan kering dengan cepatnya eh. Now I felt that when I stir. Bila saya kacau ni eh. Dia rasa agak berat. That means a little bit heavier. So that means the water has gradually evaporated. Alright. So then now I put in the oil. Baru saya taruh minyak. Okay, up to you how much minyak you want to put. Okay, don't complain. Jangan complain eh. Awak ni banyak complain. Now we cook. Kita masak. Cantik eh nampak. Okay, it looks so beautiful. I will cover this. Saya tutup. Up to you. You want to close. You want to close. Up to you. So sambal dia dah siap lah. The sambal is ready. Later we put in the crabs and the sugar. Nanti kita taruh ketam bersama gula sedikit. Okay. 4 pieces of flower crab eh. 4 ekor ketam bunga eh. Okay, this is a softer shell crab than the Sri Lankan crab eh. These are more edibles for the Muslims. Alright, rather than all the other species eh. Okay, so the blue, yang biru adalah jantan. Male. The brown is female. Betina, okay. They said, those were the days. Orang dulu kata, kalau yang pantat dia, dia punya belakang dia eh. Kalau the olden days, the people, they say they look at how to identify whether it's male or female. The male is the triangle here, elongated back. Nampak? Ni yang jantan lah. The round one is female. Betina yang bulat ni. But it's the colour, warnanya eh. Blue is male, brown is female. Senang, 4 ekor. 4 pieces, okay. This is how you clean the crab. Okay, ni macam caranya untuk membersihkan ketam eh. I saw some of the Australian friends eh. Kawan-kawan daripada Australia. Yang still have the gills here eh. These gills, we do not want. Kita tak nak gills ni eh. Dia punya, ni. This one. Gills eh. Those were the here. Ni semua tak nak. Get rid of, right? Remove the shell. Okay, and then we cut the crab into two lah. Kita potong ketam ni. Wash clean. These are all the unwanted area eh? Kotorannya, the dirt. Okay, I don't want to explain to you lah the dirt lah eh. Kita cuci kasi bersih. Okay. So first thing first, yang terutama sekarang kita masukkan dia punya sepit dulu eh. Put in the claw. Claw ni I divide into two eh. I cut into two. Okay. Here you can put in your kenol vegetarian kenol. Saya pakai kenol sayuran ni. Kenol vegetarian. Okay. After a few minutes, selepas 40 minit. Remember the balance of the asam jawa or the tamarind I soak with the crab lah. Kita ada balance kan tadi kita rendamkan dengan dia, cucikan dia, bersihkan dia, alright. So make it clean, you soak it for a while. It's okay, the tamarind is still a tamarind right. Masukkan semua. Okay. And a bit of sugar up to you eh. Terserah pada anda, sedikit gula. Now here sedikit kepal. You have to mix all the sambal all together eh. Ini mengambil sedikit masa kerana awak nak bulik-bulikkan dia eh. Sambal dia kita nak kasih rasa. Kita cover medium heat eh. Dengan api yang sederhana, okay. Okay, nampak? Kita lah isti ni lah macam kukus lah kalau awak tutup eh. Buat berapa minit. It's okay to cook a little bit longer because crab got shell eh. Ketam ni dia ada kulit. So, awak boleh tutup buat lama sedikit. You can cook longer than the prawns eh. Awak boleh masak lebih lama daripada udang. Okay. Dia tak payah air lagi, no need any more water or anything. It's supposed to be dry. Ia sepatutnya kering eh. So that's why saya tutup. That's why I cover. I want to take the steam. Dia punya wap dia eh, masak ketamnya. Okay. Okay, tu dia the peranakan sambal crab ataupun sambal ketam peranakan eh. Alamak. Oh, wow. Sabar nak cekin ke darah. Tu dia sambal ketam, the peranakan sambal ketam eh. This is the peranakan crab sambal. Oh, wow. Alamak. Selamat kembali kepada sesi cekin menyekit makan-makan eating session time. Alamak. Oh wow, kasihkan sambal ketam peranakan. This is peranakan version of the sambal crab eh. So what they usually have, they have everything. Dia ada semua bahan-bahan yang kita gunakan. They have all the ingredients for whatever the Malay cookings had or have, like ginger, lemongrass, turmeric, galangals, and whatever etc lah eh. Everything also have. Alamak, macam lubang order ubat-ubat here. Mampus eh. Begitulah, dengan cuaca yang hari ni panas pula dengan tiba-tiba suddenly. Today Sunday, hari ni hari Minggu. Kalau hari Minggu baru saya bikin saya punya masak my style eh. Only on Sunday I will do my cooking because it's my off day. Kau tengok, alamak. Ini saya makan gini je. I just eat like this only, okay. I don't have any accompanied other dishes. Saya tidak ada lauk-lauk lain ni, awak tengok. Tengok ha. Eh, dia putih kapas kalau dah masak. Once it's really really cooked, it's completely fairly white eh. Kalau tak masak, kalau dia macam transparent. Macam kelabu-kelabu, you know, when if it's not really cooked, the color is transparent, like transparent like that, kan? Because that's how the real meats are. Begitulah dengan isi ketam ni eh. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Okay, this one must just eat like that. Kena macam gini. Oh, panas nasi. Power, lama. Very dia sedap eh, memang sedap. Syok. Saya memang suka makan ketam. I like to eat ketam. But the crab is getting expensive nowadays eh. Ketam ni sekarang dengan harga dia yang agak mahal. 4 ekor ni $19 dekat Sheng Siong tau. Sheng Siong is one of the cheapest supermarket eh. $19 for this four. Awak pilih ketam ni, how to choose a crab eh? When you hold a crab, bila awak pegang ketam ni, awak boleh rasa tau berat ataupun ringan. You can feel whether it's heavy or is it light. If it's the light one, yang ringan, means it's empty, no meat. Sambal punya power. Sambal so sedap. Now, kalau awak way dia awak pegang dia, dia berat, that means dia ada isi. So I like to eat crab. So I know how to choose a crab. Now this sambal is a dry sambal. Sambal ni agak kering. So you have to watch out for your garam, your salt. Because usually you cook with gravy. Kalau awak masak yang ada kuah, awak taruh garam lebih sikit, right? So this one is a dry sambal, there is no kuah, no gravy ya. So you have to be careful with your salt dengan garam dia eh. Okay. Lama betul tak makan sambal ni. So long never eat this sambal. You can make do with prawns. Awak boleh pakai udang kalau awak tak makan ketam. Tapi kalau makan kat rumah ni memang sedap makan ketam. If you eat at home, it's nice to eat crabs lah. Because we use hands, right? Aduh, sedapnya. This is so delicious. I've been long. Dah lama nak masak ni. I have various type of crab recipe. Saya ada resepi macam-macam ketam dekat YouTube saya. Ketam my style. My style is one word. Satu perkataan my style bukan dua. Okay. Memang power lah. Memang tak rugi. Ini sambal. Tak pedas. Not, but if you use your own dry chili, will be nicer Kalau awak pakai chili kering yang di rumah punya, you make your own, will be much nicer lah. This one because they already pre-made already dah siap chili bone ni semua, dah siap factory. Macam-macam nasi pun dah habis. All is done. Very easy to cook. Senang nak masak ni Sampai boleh leleh dia. So I hope to see you again on masak-masak my style. Mam. Cuaca panas. Very hot today. But shock.